Can a granny flat have a garage or a carport? My name is Colin Fragar from Council Approval Group. Now, this is a question that I have in front of me today, and it's a question that we often get asked, and that is, your granny flat, can you have a garage or carport attached or separate to it? The answer is yes, but with some qualifications. And I actually want to show you some of the things that I did in a personal project of mine. This is actually my project, and I'm kind of proud of it. So I'm going to show you a photograph now to switch across over to here. So kind of cool granny flat, isn't it? You wouldn't almost think that's a granny flat, but it is. And it is. It fits within all the rules. It fits within the backyard. And it's not the best photograph, but over on the right-hand side, you can see a carport there. Now, this is a tip that I have for you. It depends, again, on the jurisdiction that you're in. And that is whether you can have a granny flat often depends on the order that you do it in. So with this example, what I did was I built the granny flat first, and then I used the, what they call, this was in the state of New South Wales, this one, exempt and complying provisions to be able to get an exempt carport, which didn't need council approval. One tip that I do have for you, if you are looking at doing a garage or a carport for your granny flat, is it's really important that you get the right advice, because there have been court cases which have gone all the way to the Supreme Court about a granny flat, which talk about whether the floor area within the garage, within an enclosed garage, is part of the granny flat square meter allowances. And it's really important that you don't make the same mistake that these guys did, because they actually went ahead, they built the granny flat, they had an enclosed garage, they thought that the enclosed garage was outside the ambit of the legislation, outside of the, in this case, it was 60 square meters, and it was found that it was actually no, within the 60. I'm not saying that that's a general principle that applies across the board and applies to your property. It depends on the facts of the case, depends on how your architect designs it, depends on how your town planner submits the application. So what I highly recommend, if you haven't already, is to grab your ultimate guide to achieving council approval. Please grab your copy. We'll put it in the post. It's free of charge. And also, please claim, if you haven't already, your free consultation with one of our teams so that we can help to better paint a picture for you going forward. We can maybe answer some of the questions that you have, not all of them, in that first consultation, but what we'll do is to paint a clear roadmap for you going forward so you can have clarity and certainty moving forward with your granny flat. My name is Colin Fragar from Council Approval Group. Thanks for watching, and I wish you every success.